I really wanted to make this video by the lake, but it looks like somebody's fishing out there and I don't want to bother them. So in my last video, I talked a lot about leisure and how we waste a lot of our time doing things that bring no value to us whatsoever. But I briefly talked on the obsession and compulsion of buying new things, and that's what this video is going to be about. I feel like that's something that a lot of us struggle with, and it's really hard to break the habits and change the ways of thinking that lead to this compulsion and obsession that comes with wanting something new, something that we don't have. So one of the things that we do, and it's actually the most contributing factor to this obsession with new things, is that we get excited about it. So step one, don't get excited about things. I know it's something weird to think about because it's not something that we think that we do, but as soon as something is announced, what is the first thing that we do? You know, we go to YouTube to see who posted anything about it. When is it coming in stock, you know? And that action alone is what's driving your brain to be distracted. So yeah, work on it. Work on not getting excited about things. When something new is announced, just brush it off. That's what I've been doing for the past year or so, and it's been going very well. There's rarely a thing that I'm like, okay, this is kind of cool, I kind of want this. But it's just a want, it's not a need, you know? So I guess there's things that you can justify adding in your studio. And I had somebody comment like, oh, you talk a lot about minimalism, but you always have this new gear. Well, one piece of gear comes in, two pieces of gear come out. Like, that's kind of the flow in my studio. I try to keep it as simple as possible. I've been working a lot on my guitar pedal board because my guitar has been sitting there. I bought this guitar myself. This was super expensive, and it's just been sitting there for the past year just because I've been so busy with other things. And I do play guitar, you know, I'm decent at it, and I want to get better at it. So I've been investing a lot of time in my pedal board. Hopefully I'll start making some music with guitar, because I haven't made any music or shared any music with you guys with me using guitar, and I feel like that's something that I really want to do. So basically that's my rule, especially when I had a lot of gear. If I buy something, something else needs to leave. And now at this point, I'm at the point where like everything that I own has such a specific purpose and actually means a lot to me that I don't want to sell it, so I don't get anything. Does that make any sense? Like, there's a lot of cool things out, and I'm sure there's going to be a lot of cool things announced, but you need to restrain yourself and you need to prevent yourself from getting excited. So one of the main cures for GAS, gear acquisition syndrome, is playing your instrument. Literally playing what you have, owning, loving what you have, being happy, being content with what you currently own, and not thinking that there's going to be this missing piece that is just going to make your workflow 100% perfect and that it's just magically going to make you a better musician. I always thought about it like that, like, oh, once I have this main brain or this piece of gear, like, once that happens, I'm going to be able to have everything properly running. And you know what ends up happening is that you unplug all your stuff, and then because you're waiting for that perfect setup or you're waiting for that piece of gear to arrive, and then that time that your gear isn't plugged in, you're not making any music. So, you know, you kind of justify not having your stuff plugged in because you have something new coming on the way that's gonna change your whole workflow. But what really ends up happening is that you don't make any music in all that time that you're obsessing about that one specific thing. And then once you get that thing, what's gonna happen is the cycle's just gonna repeat. You're just gonna go obsess over something else. But keeping your mind busy with things that you actually enjoy doing is the greatest favor, like the greatest thing that you can do for yourself, not only as a creative, but as a human being. And it's gonna help you stop craving those things, you know, because if you're busy learning your instrument or being creative or journaling or whatever, going outside, being with people, being social, you're not going to be busy obsessing over the things that you don't have and the things that you want. I hope you guys like this content. Like I said, I want to take my channel in like a different direction. I'm just tired of making reviews and tutorials, and I mean, I do like teaching, and I'm not going to stop teaching. Like, I'm not gonna stop making tutorials about synthesizers and stuff, but it's gonna be very scarcely. Like, it's gonna be something that I have to be super excited about, and that is actually going to be part of my workflow, not just something random that somebody send me in exchange for a review. Like, I'm done doing that. It doesn't bring me any happiness, and in the long run, it just gives me a material thing that is just gonna be straining on my soul, and you know, less is more for me, at least. So I try to stay away from that type of content now. I feel good about making these videos. I feel good about sharing the things that are helping me be a better person and a better creative. I want to thank you guys for sticking around and, you know, letting me know in the comments that you guys like this type of content. Like, it's kind of hard to think about where this channel is going to go, and I don't really want to say in which way specifically it's going to go. But knowing that you guys aren't just here for reviews, you know, that kind of pushes me in a different direction, and it kind of pushes me to be better and be more open and be more myself and not not be so scripted. Like, I feel these videos are a lot more meaningful and they hold a greater value to the community. If you feel that way, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also turn on the notifications so you know whenever I make a new video, which isn't gonna be as constant as I was before, because I really want to put more time into these videos and really more thought and really make meaningful content. Content that isn't rushed, that I'm not feeling like I'm trying to meet a certain deadline for anybody, because I'm just doing this for myself now. And if you guys like this type of content and you want to see more like it, the way that you can help me succeed is by checking out my Patreon or checking out my sample and sound packs on my website, dollisjamming.com. I also sell like synthesizer shirts. Like, I draw these shirts. It's like music producer swag. That's kind of what I call it. And I try to make at least like one new design a month. We'll see how that goes. But yeah, and it pushes me to make myself, to create new content, and to just, you know, gets the creative juices flowing when I design these type of shirts, because it's more than just merch, you know, like it's an actual shirt that a musician's gonna wanna wear. It's not just like a shirt with my name on it. But yeah, again, thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate you. If you can't afford to be a patron, you know, don't worry. I understand. Thank you guys so much for being here, and I'll catch you in the next one.